Well, he was a key architect in Western Australia's response to the pandemic. Now the Deputy Premier has turned his attention to the recovery of the state's tourism sector as WA reconnects with the world. And Tourism Minister and Deputy Premier Roger Cook joins us now. Good evening to you.
Good evening. Thanks for the opportunity to be with you.
Well, we are loving being here, but as Tourism Minister, tell us what's the one thing that we should do while we're here in Perth?
Well, look, I want everyone to wander out yonder. We really want people to experience the great tourism products that we have here in Western Australia, whether it's the wineries down south, the incredible reefs that we, coral reefs we have up in Exmouth, or you experienced Broome earlier in the week, Lisa. And as you can see, Western Australia has so much to offer. We want everyone to wander out yonder and really experience it.
Roger, it's been suggested the tourism here, industry here, may take up to 2 years to fully recover. What hope can you give to people in the industry right now?
Yeah, well, obviously, within the tourism industry itself, they've had varying experiences of the pandemic. If you're in hospitality or accommodation, you potentially have had two of the best years of your business. Everyone within Western Australia has been going out and experiencing everything that Western Australia has to offer. So places like Broome, Margaret River, Geraldton, everywhere in Kalgoorlie. The accommodation services have done pretty well. The people who have done it really tough are our tour operators, those people who are, you know, offering those day experiences or extended tour experiences. And they're the ones that we need to continue to support. And they're the ones that we really need people to be able to now go out and spend their money, spend their time and really experience everything that that those tour operators have to offer. Lisa, I think you spent some time with Bart Pigram earlier in the week.
Oh, I did.
Walking tour of Broome, which is a great experience,
yeah.
And he's running a terrific operation there.
Yeah. And recommend that to everyone.
That's another example of just what we have to have here in Western Australia.
There's no doubt you've got great products. That's not the issue. Am I right in saying your requirement is triple vaxxed for overseas visitors to come into WA?
Look, we're getting a little bit stuck around some of the complexities of this. If you're coming directly into Western Australia, you're actually welcomed into the state by the federal government, so
right. You're
double vaxxed in that particular instance. But we're requiring all our interstate arrivals at this point in time to be triple vaxxed, and that would include anyone who's already come to the country via another state. Look, these things will continue to play out over the next few weeks. The announcement by the Premier today with the easing of restrictions going down to what we call pretty much level one restrictions from next Thursday night is obviously a welcome change. And as we come off the peak of the pandemic, we'll be in a position to have more easing of restrictions. And that's good news for everyone.
I noticed you gazing in the Nat's eyes before. I know you're a big Freo Docker supporter. Did you bring anything to sign? Did you want your tie signed? Or?
Well, look, and obviously we're very sad that Nat's having some problems with his back at the moment. But look, to be honest, I'm a huge Dockers fan, but I'm more a league and union kind of guy. But look, over the last 2 years, I've watched great leaders in action, watching the Premier take this state forward. And I recognise in Nat a great leader for the Dockers. And I think it's a pleasure to watch him lead that side.
Lisa's married to a former Wallaby. Do you want her to sign something?
Absolutely. <yes.
All> right. Wow, your eyes really lit up then. Okay, thank you so much for your time.
Great to be
really
with you.
Really appreciate
Thanks
it.
Thanks very much.